Guys, we are live and it's time for us to finally look at the Data Pack 7 PaaS version 1.07, and it's time for us to look at the current confirmed issues and the fixes. Hopefully they have fixed the gameplay. And as you can see, guys, it's literally 1.5 gigabytes in size, and I always like this this video packages. I always love them, really. I always love them, especially in the old PaaS. Alright guys, so we are going to be reviewing the EURO offline content, and as you can see, I think the first thing we can just do is just to review the cup. So as you can see, when you go to kickoff, we have a new option, which is the EURO UEFA Cup local match, and also the cup, like, so we have the local match and the cup. I think we're going to go with the local match, really, because it's quite precise and, you know, simple. We don't have to go through the group stage and things like that. But I think I'll also review the cup, like, right after this, you know, so that we can just have a general feeling of it. So we have our nice live update going on. We've got Czech Republic on B form. I'm not sure why other teams are on C form and Czech is on B form and other teams are not even in form. But anyways, let's just see what we have with all these countries, Ukraine, Turkey. I think the presentation looks nice. I'm not sure why they didn't give us... Look at it. The game looks the same. The interface looks the same like this. But then it's just when you go within the tournament that the interface changes. I wish they had given us a different interface altogether. Like new overlays, new skins. Just to celebrate, you know, and honor this whole DLC. But it's Konami and they're lazy and yada yada yada. I'm not going to get into that. So live update in progress. And we're just going to try to make a review of the gameplay. Maybe a 15 minutes review of the gameplay, guys. I'm going to go with Ukraine. Because Ukraine, they have a lot of players from Ukraine that have had their, you know, like faces updated and stuff like that. Wait, alright, Netherlands. You know, maybe they'll be... Do you remember, guys, when PaaS used to call them oranges? I remember that. New stadiums. Let's check out the stadium. So we have a football arena, which we already had. We have a new stadium, Wembley Stadium, and St. Petersburg. I'm not sure which one we can choose, but okay, I think we're going to choose both, right? One match in Petersburg, one match in Wembley Stadium. Yeah, the kits look nice. I really like this, the blue Ukrainian kit, really. I like it. You know, it looks nice. I feel like the blue Ukrainian kit looks nice, really nice. So yeah, we've got okay, very nice kits, really. The kits are nice, the visual presentation looks nice, the graphics look nice. Konami have literally nailed it to the T. Like, they have literally mastered the art of graphic presentation, design, player models. But the gameplay, oh look at that, looks very nice. Hopefully they've changed the crowd reaction, because, you know, the crowd reaction in PaaS is the same. Faces look nice. Van Dijk looks awesome. Like the lighting. Play animations look nice. The presentation looks real. Looks like a real tournament. It has that, you know, that EURO tournament to it. I say EURO. That UEFA EURO tournament to it. Alright, the Ukrainian people raising their... the banners, the flags, the scarves, including the orange Dutch scarves to the right. The faces look nice. The faces are nice. The presentation is nice, guys. Looks very realistic, you know. But the problem that I have is online. Online is neglected. Even offline, man, really. They have not really changed the overlays. But anyways, let's just enjoy this. National anthem is forlorn. Jerseys, the keys look nice. Very nice. Very, very nice. Oh, actually, the national anthems are correct, are accurate. I always thought that they would put like some generic music, but it seems as if the national anthems are accurate. I don't know why the goalkeeper has a generic face. Anyways, Looks nice, really. Right, we're gonna look at the interface. The interface, the overlays look quite different. I didn't point that out at the start, but it looks nice. It looks realistic. It looks very cool. It looks very modern, which Konami have been struggling to do. So it seems as though Konami need third-party developers because this is clearly EUR influence. You know, it was designed by the EUR designers and then given to Konami. I'm liking the presentation, really. Right, oh, nice animation. The camera, I'm not really feeling the camera, but is this a default camera? I'm not sure. Look at that touch, guys. You see what I'm saying? What was that touch? You see that shit, guys? Like, it's not. Look at that touch, man. It's not a smooth game. Like, it is smooth, but there's some moments where it's just really absurd. Like, look at that, man. Overhead pass. Guys, look at that. Oh my god. The passes are getting underhead and overhead. Whatever, man. Oh, bro, we got it. You know, sometimes PES at its best is a good video game. But sometimes, man, it's just ridiculous, you know? Look at that, guys. Did you see what happened there? Just let the ball really ball watch a lot. Look at the. You see what. Oh my god, man. That's the problem I have with PES, like I told you. Players are unaware of what's happening in the match most of the times. The guy just got. You know what, guys? Never mind. We're just gonna play one half, and then that's it. But I think this one needs me to be a bit slower, because. All right, that was quite quick and fast. Junior Moraes. Right, let's go with France. See some Griezmann, Giroud, Kante, Varane. Have to change the stadium, St. Petersburg. Right, I'm liking this presentation, really. You know, the design, the overlay looks nice. We have Manuel Neuer. There is Manuel Neuer. We have Hugo Lloris. Presentation again is really this. I think the atmosphere in PES is too lacking. Like, once you see it the first time, you have seen everything. Like, as you can see, guys, this looks exactly the same as from last match we played. Which was Ukraine versus, what was it? Ukraine versus what? I don't remember. But it looks the same, really. Almost the same thing, you know. Oh, it was Ukraine versus Netherlands. Looks almost the same. Looks very much the same. No difference at all. So, I don't know, guys. Once you see it, once you have seen everything. And this is where PES, and also the crowd, the reaction is the same. The reception is the same. No difference. I miss the days when PES used to have Club ID. Those days were really nice. German national anthem seems nice, sounds really nice. Genta's face really looks nice, really. Makes you want to buy him. And Tar also looks nice, really.
Well, there are plenty looking forward to seeing this.
Coach. Oh, I have Coach as a defender. Wow. Commentary looks this. Sorry, sounds the same, really. I don't know, guys. I'm not really impressed. If you tell me right now to rate this, I'll give it at least a 6 out of 10. At least they've tried, you know, but. Nice looking ball, by the way, and nice looking grass. Right there, Otaki. They're playing with Otaki fullbacks. Who's that? Toni Kroos. That was nice. Nice defending from him. Oh my. Oh, we just scored from a rebound, guys. Nice. The celebration always gets me. Wow. It always gets me, guys, for real. Right, now we are trying to maintain the lead. Dude, I like Kimmich's positioning, really. I think it's nice. That was close. I'm enjoying the match, really, but the game is still the same. And that's the truth to be told. Alright, guys, yeah, I think you can hear the A from the crowd, so yeah. I don't know, guys, I think that's it, really. Here we are, guys, the currently confirmed issues, so match day, an issue occurring in match day events using preset teams that prevents players from being set as, players to join attack. So if you want to set players to join attack, you can't in match day. I haven't really seen this issue, really. This issue is triggered by switching substitute players into your starting lineup from the game plan screen. You can avoid triggering this issue by exiting and re-entering game plan. Alright, I haven't seen this, but if it has been a real issue, then they have to fix it. A fix planned for an upcoming update. Guys, a new Dota pack is upon us. Dota pack 7, which is compatible with the PES version 1.07, is available. We're going to look at it. We're going to look at the new features. We're going to look at the fixes. I hope a gameplay fix has been implemented, because a gameplay fix is what we really want. Nothing else. What we really want and what's really important right now is a gameplay fix. Without a gameplay fix, this is boosh, you know, boosh. I'm not going to say the word, but you know what I'm trying to say. Because PES is in dire need of a gameplay fix. You might fool us with the skins, with the overlays. Like, honestly speaking, the gameplay is so broken that without a gameplay fix, you know, there's no reason to play the game. Alright, let me stop my ranting and raging. Let's just jump into it. So, EURO exclusive content, I think. Alright, so official EURO licenses. New several cinematics and animations. New stadiums. Alright, so the Gazprom Arena and Wembley Stadium have been added. Cup mode has been added. Master League and Become a Legend, the Cup mode has also been added. Local match mode has been added. Official EURO match mode has been added. Updates, so new season data for Campeonato AFP. I think, yeah, the Chilean League. updated club strips, updated national teams, updated club team emblems. I'm not sure which team emblems. New updated fest models. I had the 74 faces that have been updated, but mainly low rated players, but it's still a great thing, you know, they have to update faces. New player updated portraits. They have to update player portraits. I hope they updated Matuidi's player portrait, because it's just a joke. New manager portraits, updated player names, great. Changes. My club added option to select national team as your base team. Right, great. I think since we're in the EU campaign, that has to be done. Fixes. This is the important part. My club fixes. An issue that caused incorrect team strength value to be displayed in the squad list for all teams that include players from Iconic Moments series. Right? This issue was triggered by using matchday team that differs to your base team. So how is this possible? Matchday team that differs from your base team. Wait, how do you use a matchday team different from your base team? Oh, I get it. So if you are, if your base team is Manchester United, if you're using a Manchester United badge and kits, and then you use a team that has different players that are not Manchester United players, right? I get it. An issue where, and also for example, if your base team is Manchester United and in matchday you select Barcelona and use Barcelona players, I get it. An issue where team strength level filter for matchmaking in ranked matches did not work correctly. I think this is really true. I've been matched with people that are 5-star in a 4-star only mode, so I'm not sure why. Anyways, this issue was triggered by switching to normal squad from club edition squad that differ from a base team. Alright, I get it. Gameplay. An issue which sometimes caused lofted passes kicked with full power or gauge to fall short of their target when using manual controls. So this is the only gameplay feature they have fixed. Other updates, variety of minor adjustments. This is a problem that I have with PES. The Electrons, what are a variety of minor adjustments? Tell us the minor adjustments. Because at this point, you know, they don't want us to blame them, you know. They don't want to take responsibility of the game being bad. So if they say a variety and they clearly don't specify what exactly, we can't hold them accountable. This is the problem that I have with PES. We cannot hold them accountable because a variety of minor adjustments. We don't know what the minor adjustment is. It could be 0, it could be 1, it could be 2, it could be 100. Tell us exactly what you mean. You just told us you fixed an issue with lofted passes using manual controls. And then you go on to say other updates. Honestly speaking, man, this company just doesn't listen to fans. Konami, when are you gonna listen to fans? When are you gonna listen to fans? Alright, guys, you know what? We're gonna have to do an offline, you know, just an offline look at it again. And then, yeah, I'm just frustrated with Konami, really. So we're gonna make an online, you know, review. And then after that, we're gonna do an offline review. Okay. Online review. Do we have new modes? Do you have new content? What do we have? Let's just jump into it and see. Alright, okay. So what's new? Online Challenge Cup is the same crap. Online Challenge Cup is the same crap. No new Online Challenge Cup, nothing. That's Konami for you guys. We have been passed. I think maybe on Monday they're going to release something. But at least release something today, because it's the day of the, you know, the new Dota Pack release hype. No new tournaments whatsoever, nothing. So there you have it, guys. Online, there's nothing. So the only thing we're going to have to do right now is to just make spins, I guess. Free spins. Thank you, Konami, for the free spins. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We've just been Konami'd. Nothing, no cups, no new content, just one gameplay fix and minor fixes, and that's it. Nothing else, nothing's new, no new managers, nothing's new. The same my club, the same tournaments, the same gameplay. Nothing is new, nothing has been changed.